the last video, we talked about, last two videos, we talked about what are eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Now we're going to begin the process of figuring out how to compute eigenvalues and eigenvectors. And this all has to do with something called the characteristic polynomial of a matrix. It only helps us find the eigenvalues. We'll worry about the eigenvectors later. So the object of the game is somebody hands us an n by n matrix, and for our purposes, let's just think in terms of the matrix 2, 1, 1, 2. It's a nice simple example. And we want to find the eigenvalues, and we'll worry about the eigenvectors later. So we want to have a test to see whether a number is an eigenvalue. And then once we've got a test, we can figure out what are the numbers that pass the test, and then we'll have our eigenvalues. So let's walk through this. If a number lambda is an eigenvalue, that means that we can find an eigenvector. That is to say, we can find a non-zero vector such that ax is lambda x. And another way to write lambda x is lambda times the identity matrix times x, because of course the identity matrix times x is just x. Okay, well if we can do that, then we can put the lambda times the identity on the other side of the equation, and we can write lambda times the identity minus a times x is 0 for some non-zero x. Except, you know, most matrices, the only solution to that matrix times x equals 0 is the trivial solution. If you have a non-trivial solution, that means that there's something special about this matrix. It means that that when you row reduce it, you don't get the identity. You get some other matrix. You've got fewer than n pivots. So the columns are linearly independent, so you can find some linear combination that's zero. And how can we test whether a matrix is singular? Well, we have this magic oracle called the determinant. That if the determinant is zero, then the matrix is singular. And if the determinant is non-zero, then the matrix is non-singular. So in other words, lambda is an eigenvalue if and only if this funny determinant is zero. So we give this funny determinant a name. We call it the characteristic polynomial of A. It depends on lambda, of course. It's a polynomial in the variable lambda, and it depends on what the matrix A is. Different matrices will have different polynomials. So this is the characteristic polynomial of A. And the eigenvalues of A are exactly those values of lambda that make the characteristic polynomial equal to zero. Now, the polynomial itself, when you compute this n by n determinant, you're always going to get n powers of lambda. So it's an nth order polynomial, and then you get other terms. You know, it's not exactly lambda to the n, it's lambda to the n plus something, lambda to the n minus 1, all the way down. It's an nth order polynomial. And you know that an nth order polynomial has at most n roots. That means that an n by n matrix can have at most n eigenvalues. So if I give you a 2 by 2 matrix and you found two eigenvalues, you're done. It can't possibly have any more than that. So let's work an example. Our favorite matrix, the matrix 2, 1, 1, 2, and then the identity matrix is 1, 0, 0, 1. You multiply that by lambda, you get lambda 0, 0, lambda. And now we want to look at the matrix lambda times the identity minus A. So you would just put lambdas in the diagonal, and then you copy all the entries of A only with a minus sign. And then the characteristic polynomial is the determinant of that matrix. And you know how to take the determinant of a 2 by 2 matrix. It's this times this minus this times this. So it gives you lambda minus 2 squared minus 1. You multiply it all out, and you get lambda squared minus 4 lambda plus 3. So the characteristic polynomial of this matrix is lambda squared minus 4 lambda plus 3. Now, okay, you got the characteristic polynomial. Next thing is to find the eigenvalues. Well, those are just the roots of this quadratic polynomial. You can use a quadratic formula. You plug it in, 4 plus or minus 2 over 2, and you get that the roots are 1 and 3, and that means that the eigenvalues of the matrix are 1 and 3. Now again, that doesn't tell you the eigenvectors. It just tells you what the eigenvalues are. We'll tackle the eigenvectors in the next video.